It's not everywhere, but it is still in my liver. So, you know, it leads you to new crossroads. You have to make new decisions with treatment plans and surgery plans. I've had 4 major surgeries that take you out of service for a month to 6 weeks at a time. My name is Brian Beck. I live in Etheridge, Tennessee. I am 59 years old, and I have a diagnosis of colon cancer with metastasis to my liver. I work as a nurse practitioner in a regional hospital in a specialty clinic. Married, we have 2 daughters, 7 grandchildren. I have hobbies around home. I do some woodworking, try to garden, play with the grandchildren as much as possible, you know, enjoy myself in those ways. I was encouraged by my primary care physician to do routine screening. I was 54 and had never been screened. Well, I'm a nurse practitioner. I felt like I would know if there was something going on with my body. So the colonoscopy on January the 8th, 2019, was positive for a tumor that was in my sigmoid colon. My family reacted very appropriately, I think. It's never not emotional when you get a diagnosis of cancer, but you know, we all worked together and decided on, you know, what would be best, not only for me, but for the whole family and to how to move forward. So my first treatment was FOLFOX with Avastin. And it was successful. We had that treatment for roughly a year, stopped the treatments, and we moved forward with routine scan. So the next scan after I completed my treatment did show that I had a new lesion on my liver. So I landed at Vanderbilt. They started me on a trial, 3 med trial. It was Opdiva, Vectibix, and Yervoy. And those are immunotherapies. Went through that and basically had the same type of success, and then repeat scans later after stopping treatment indicated new lesions. So progressed through different treatments. I've had immunotherapy and now I'm on targeted therapy after I've had another recurrence. Tukysa and Herceptin is what I'm on now. My cancer has always responded very well to treatments. But my cancer has been very persistent, although not aggressive. After 2 or 3 scans, we'll have a recurrence. We're hoping for great response in the future with these meds, and you know, maybe this will be the one that will prevent the recurrence in the future. I'm very lucky, I think, in that I've been able to work the whole time. Even since I have been diagnosed, I think I'm here to help take care of other people. And I think because I get up and do it, I'm able to get up and do. Going through this journey, I feel like I can help people with theirs. No one thinks they're going to get cancer. That's what happens to other people, but it can happen to you. You know, one thing that I would like to make sure that I share is screening. The proactiveness of routine screening could, you know, impact their lives in ways that they would never realize, you know, if they wait too long. Cancer research is near and dear to me because of my benefit from it. I'm 4.5 years in. Almost every treatment that I've had from a cancer perspective has been based on research. What I would hope in the future, monies could continue to be allocated for future research and, you know, find ways to improve the treatment plans, to have more success with them, to do more trials, and to, you know, save more people.